Yeah, shalom, 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 Israel. First of all, give your praise to the Most High, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahshem, and yeah, man. Today's lesson that we touch on today is basically the slave trade, innit, man? It's been willing, to, been a long time, and been willing to do this lesson, but Spirit jumped to me today to like to bring it up, man. So like they say, man, you can't quench the spirit, innit, man. So like the words gotta get it regardless, man, innit. The truth's got to get out regardless, man. Like they say, man, that what's in the darkness, man, shall come to the light, man. And basically, man, before I get any precepts in, I'm just gonna read two articles, man. It's basically touching on to basically the slave trade, innit, man. It's basically that what the West Indians went through, man. So I'm not gonna ramble too on about this, man. I'm just gonna read this article and basically bring out some precepts, man. This lesson ain't gonna be too long, man. So one sec, let me zoom in a bit. See, it says the slave trade. So let me read it. It says the transatlantic slave trade is largely responsible for bringing to the Americans enslaved Africans. See that? Basically, it's meant to say Israelites, innit? Because like obviously, the Israelites went through slavery, innit, and slave ships, man. And we're the one that was in slavery and hard bondage, man. But obviously, people that write these articles, man, they don't know that that were really, really and truly were the Israelites, man. That's what people went through slavery on slave ships, man. It was the Israelites, not the Africans. But let me carry on though. The slave trade is said to have drawn between 10 and 20 million Africans from their homeland approximately 600,000 coming to Jamaica, one of the largest importer of slaves at the time, between 1533 and 1807. See that? Referred to as the triangular trade, it involved three points: Europe, Africa, and the West Indians, and recipiented slucky. Represented a complex financial business at its peak. In the 18th century, the cruel and inhuman conditions experienced by the Africans from their intentional capture, their journey along the Middle Passage and enslaved in the West Indies demanded that the slave trade be abolished and slaves be freed, and much agitation, slucky for that, by anti-slavery individuals and groups in and outside of the Caribbean, as well as passive and active residents by the slucky. Let me zoom that a bit. The Maroons, as well as the slave trade, abolition bill was passed in the British House of the Lords on the 25th of March, 1807. It's the last bit now. The bicentenary of the abolition of the slave trade, 2007. In the British West Indies is being recognized in Jamaica and other regions. In acknowledgement of this year as an important historical event, the National Library of Jamaica has compiled a select Griff Slucky, mate. Let me just go back to that Slucky. One sec. Slucky. The biography of materials available on the subject in its collections. The National Library of Jamaica holds a number of materials on the slave trade, see that? Dating as far back as 1671 and publications from each century thereafter. Yeah, that's right, man. So that it's all in history, man. There's no way you're getting around it, man, because they want to say that these heathens want to say, man, like when you bring up slavery, man, say that look how long that was, look how long ago that was, man. Can't you get over it, man? Like, man, you can't get over it, man. It's in history, man. So like the precept says, man, in Ecclesiasticus, man, says surely oppression will make a wild man mad, man. So all the stuff that we're seeing, even me when I was in primary school and secondary school, innit? I was basically like watching certain movies, innit, man, certain history stuff, innit, and basically saying telling us like how we went through slavery, innit, man. But obviously they wasn't showing us how we was ruling Scotland and England for way over hundreds of years, man. They wasn't telling us that, was it? So I'm saying there's a lot of stuff that was hiding in these schools, man. And right now in today's society, man, like they're not putting our history in these schools, man. They're trying to get rid of all of our history, man. They're starting to remove all these slavery films from the schools and stuff like that, man. So I'm saying, man, it's people are wicked, man, trying to remove our history, man. But obviously slavery is a part of history, but really and truly, before slavery times, was ruling these heathens, man. But they're not gonna put that in these schools, man. That's what I'm saying. We need to come back to our history, man. Come back to the Bible, man. The King James Bible, 1611. Basically, the Apocrypha as well, man. So it's lucky. Got a message once anyway. Yeah. So I'm gonna read the next article after. I'm gonna get a couple precepts in, man. After that, man. Wind down, man. So Slucky is another article. It's a long article. I'm not even gonna read all this, man. We'll be here all day, man. I'm just gonna read probably the first paragraph, and that's it, man. Yeah, let me zoom in a bit. So, okay, it basically says it's basically the history of Jamaica, innit? So let me read this bit. The Caribbean island of Jamaica was intentionally inhabited in approximately 600 AD or 650 AD by the Redware people, often associated with Redware pottery. By roughly 800 AD, a second wave of inhabitants occurred by the Arawak tribes, including the Tainos, Pura. To the arrival of Columbus in 1494, early inhabitants of Jamaica named Slucky the land. See, yeah, these words are kind of mad, storm, man. Azamaca, meaning land of wood and water. See that? Yeah, man. So like how the brothers say that we're out in highs and buyers, man. Like, we always say that, we tell people like, what does Jamaica represent, man? And proof's in the pudding right now, because showing you right now, it says that Jamaica just means the land of wood and water, man. That's what Jamaica means, man. So let me carry on, man. I'm slacking my verse, man. The Spanish enslaved the Arawak, who were ravaged further by diseases by the Spanish brought with them. Early historians believe that by 1602, the Arawak, speaking Taino, tribes, Saki, were extinct. However, some of the Thai Aino escaped into the forested mountains of the interior, where they mixed with runaway African slaves and surviving runaway African slaves and survive free from first Spanish and then English rule. Yeah, sit man. So it's basically a lot of history, man. If you wanna read up for yourself, you can basically tap on can't remember what even tapped into for me to get this up, man. Basically just tap in history of Jamaica, man, and basically it should come upon Wikipedia, and it should come upon that history thing, man. So yeah, you kind of get into that on your own, man, because I'm not gonna be here all day reading all this this article. This article is probably like don't even know how long it's probably like take you probably at least a couple of days to read, man. There's a lot of meat in this this article, man. So I just wanted to show you that basically that what Jamaica means, and it means wood and water, and basically that it's a lot of history behind that zone, man. So yeah, man. So people need to read about, man, and basically not just read about, man, to basically that do research, man, and basically watch these movies and show you what we went through, man. Show us who we are in the Bible, man. We're not just no black people, man. We're not just no niggas, man. We're God's chosen people, man. As it says in Deuteronomy 7 verse 6, man. We're above all people upon the earth, man. Above these heathens, man. So where we're going, man, don't be putting your head down to the ground, man. Make sure your head's hold up high, man. Because we're kings on the earth, man. And our sisters are princesses, man. They're not no queens, man. They're princesses, man. Not no bad bees, man. So let me get see how many priests I've got in there, man. Scan on my laptop, man. Say it, man. Try to make it go slow, but see that. Mad thing, man. Yeah, it's got probably like 4 priests, man. After when I close out, man. Let me start from Deuteronomy first, actually. Yeah. It's a book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. By the way, I spake unto thee. So I have to read it again. Deuteronomy 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. By the way, whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt say it no more again. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies, not your friends, unto your enemies, for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you. So the only people went for slavery, man, and slave ships, man, is the 12 tribes of Israel, man. That's who went for slavery and slave ships, man. It wasn't the whole world that went for slavery and slave ships, man. So when we read this this precept out, man, no one should get into their feelings, man. Because when we bring up peace about one, notice when we bring up peace about one, when we're out there, hives and buyers, man. A lot of people want to say like they're the Hebrew Israelites, man. These heathens are not the Hebrew Israelites, man. The Hebrew Israelites are the people that went through slavery and slave ships, man, and hard bondage, man. That's who the Hebrew Israelites are, man. It's not a religion thing either, man. It's a bloodline thing, man. It's not a colour thing either, because like that guy from Prison Break, man, can't remember his name, man, because I haven't watched that show before, but brother from America, from HOS, showed me, man, basically showed me, like, who his dad is, man. His dad is, can't remember what country he's from, but his dad is an Israelite, man. His dad's a dark-skinned man regardless, man. So, but obviously, he came out light for some reason, man, because that's what it says in Numbers 1 verse 8, man. God's by the seed of the father, man. So whatever the father is, that's what the son's going to be, man. Because a lot of brothers and sisters, man, they come out light, man. But when it's more time, when you do research, man, the more likely to be an Israelite, man. Only if they went through, only if the father and the forefather went through slavery on slave ships, man. Hard bondage, only if that, man. We don't just when we're out in the house, we don't just call people Israelite for no reason, man. We bring out Numbers 1 verse 18 and basically that. We lick it from there, man. We don't just go by the skin colour, man. Cause a lot of people get confounded, man, when you're out in the house, and even certain times I get confounded sometimes, cause sometimes I might
think that guy's an Israelite, but really and truly, you might be a heathen, and that's why you gotta basically bring out Numbers 1 verse 18 and more, man, because I'll see certain times brothers doing out there at camp, man, like, they don't bring out Numbers 1 verse 18, man, just say, like, brother, you're Israelite, man, you can't just be saying that, you need to ask the brother, what country is his dad from, man, and basically, bring out Numbers 1 verse 18, man, and basically, like, see if the spirit beareth witness, man. So let me get the next precept in, man. Get Proverbs chapter. Proverbs chapter 22, verse 16. Yes, book of Proverbs chapter 22 verse 16. He that oppresseth the poor to increase his riches, and he that giveth to the rich shall surely come to want. See that? You read all that again, man. Proverbs 22 verse 16. He that oppresseth the poor to increase his riches, and he that giveth to the rich shall surely come to want. See that? So that says that the first point, man, says that he that oppresseth the poor, man. Who's the oppressor of the poor right now, man? These heathens, man, they're oppressing the poor every day, man. Because, like, even right now in this Babylon place, man, in the UK, man, got cost of living going on right now, man. But these heathens still not basically these heathens still not increase the prices and stuff, man, like the food and that, man. They're not increase the prices on the gas, man, on the rent, man, and so on, man. It's when they're keeping increasing the price, and too, this place gets destroyed, man, because obviously, like I said, man, I remember that priest again, man, basically, they should build, but obviously, the Most High is going to throw it down, man, so he can keep him building these construction sites, man, but the Most High, when all hell breaks loose, man, Most High is going to send his son down Yahweh Shai, man, and basically going to destroy all this wicked Babylon place, man, because that heathens going to think that this earth is going to last forever, man. Like, man, the earth's not going to last forever, man. It's only a certain time frame that the Most High allowed these heathens to rule, man. But when all hell breaks loose, man, it's people in for a real awakening, man, because that, like, right now these rich-ass heathens and these other celebrities, man, they think they can hide in the bunkers, man. Like, you can't be, you're not gonna hide into your bunkers, man. Cause like that guy called Mark Zuckerberg from Facebook, man, he said even mentioned, man, like, basically, like, said he's building bunkers, man, so he doesn't have to face. Actually, he didn't even say that, man. He said he's building bunkers, man, and if you're reading for yourself, man, you can kind of put two and two together, man. Cause the reason why he's building bunkers, man, because he knows what's gonna come to pass, man. Even that guy called Rick Ross, man. I'm gonna play it after this as well, man. I'll show you, like, what you're saying, man. He's talking some folly, man. He's saying, like, how he's gonna build some bunkers, man. He's gonna be making some wings in his bunkers as well, man. He's talking folly, man. They think, like, even these certain jakes, man, they think they can hide in their bunkers, man. If you're not keeping the law of statutes and commands, man, the Most High is gonna destroy you, man. Simple as that, man. Don't matter if you're Jake or not, man. If you're not keeping the laws, statutes, and commands, man, the Most High is not dealing with you if you're not keeping the laws, statutes, and commands, unless you repent, man. So let me get two more priests off, and see if I can find a video. It's the book of Exodus chapter 21 verse it's the book of Exodus chapter 21 verse 16. And he that stealeth a man and selleth him, or if he be found. Slucky, read it again, Slucky. Exodus 21, verse 16. And he that stealeth a man and selleth him, or if he be found in his hand, he shall surely be put to death. So, like, these heathen nation, man, what they've done to us on slavery times, man, that. Like it says, man, he that stealeth a man and selleth him, and so when our forefathers in slavery, man, and our foremothers in slavery times, man, basically, there was They're stealing us as well, man. They're basically selling us on auction blocks, man, saying 59.52 sold on it, man. They're basically selling us on auction blocks, man. And they even showed you in these slavery movies, man, they basically like, they love to steal these our people, man, basically, like, and sell us for like for peanuts, man. Even showed you in that movie called Get Out, man. They was basically planning to basically do some auction thing, man. It's basically planning to basically like once they capture the most of these jakes, man, they're gonna basically gonna start to sell them, man, and basically like, kind of watch that movie in yourself as for yourself as well, and because it even shows you that like, they wouldn't like try and lick us down and basically like, use our body parts, man. Because I'm saying, man, is a movie come out and I can't remember when exactly when the movie came out, but I watched that movie in the cinema, man. So a lot of truth in that movie, man. It even showed you like we shouldn't be dealing with these Beckys, man, these Karens, man, these other nations, man. Because like what showed you at the end of the movie, man, that Karen, that she the man, basically like when it's time for that guy to leave the house, man, she basically like she lied to the that Jake, man, said she can't find the keys, man, basically locked him inside the house, man, and basically Nina got him licked down, man. So I'm not gonna talk too much in that movie, man. Kind of watch the movie in yourself, man. So let me get the last preset of today, man. Book of Revelation chapter let me start from then actually. It's Book of Revelations chapter, it's one of my laptops, lucky. Say and try to mess my connection, man. See that? Man, let me go. Oh, see, can't go praise, man. It's Book of Revelation, chapter 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with a sword must be killed with a sword. Didn't say might be killed with a sword, said must be killed with a sword. Here's the patience and the faith of the saints. So everything will these heathens done to us on Syria, man, this payback for that, man. So any heathen that says they're gonna get away with what their forefathers done to us, man. Yeah, they're in for a real awakening, man. Cause they think they can get away with what they done to us, man. The Most High only gave them a certain amount of time to be ruling right now, man, so they can buy the nice penthouses, man, buy the nice sports cars, man, go to these horse riding events, man, and go to these football matches as well, man. But when Yahusha returns with here as a thief and that, man, the time's up, man, because a lot of these heathens are proud as well, man. When we bring out this precept, man, not just this precept, man, many other precepts as well, man, saying like how you gotta pay for what you done to us in slavery times, man. They wanna say like can't you get over it, man. Can't you forget about what our forefathers done to us, man. We can't forget what you've done to us, man, because in Ecclesiastes 7 verse 7 says, surely oppress them and make a wise man mad, man. If you're not mad right now, man, you must be a damn fool, man, because surely if their forefathers was in slavery as well, they'll be upset as well, man. So like that's why when you walk past a heathen or a sheathen, man, all these other nation, man, they wanna put their head down to the ground, man. They wanna cross the road, man. They wanna smile in the face, man. Cause really and truly, they got guilt inside of in a soul, man. They know that the time's come to end, man. That's why when we're out there in hives and byes, man, when we bring out the word, man, they wanna run past the camp, man, and basically wanna put their head down to the ground, man, and basically wanna smile on it, man. They know the time's come to end, man. So yeah, sit, man. So before I close up, man, see if I can find this quick video clip, man, after I'm not wind down after this one. So lucky, okay, man. So. Just gonna go to the short one. I'm not gonna play with that. I didn't even go to the 4 minute one still. See that man said he bought off 5.8 million. Actually, no, it's actually stuck here. I'm trying to see. Yeah, he's a madman, man. Is what he's saying. Let me read this before clicking. It says Rick Ross shows where he will build his bunker for Doomsday, his fish tank, etc., on his Miami island. Yeah, this guy's a madman, man. I think that the bunker's gonna save him from when all hell's breaking loose, man. So
Let me click on this thing, see if it's the right one. But
this most definitely creative. I'm having a boss conversation.
Oh, here it is. Yeah. I was wrong.
This most definitely creative. I'm having a boss conversation with one of my homies, and he said, "What's one of the bosses' moves that you pulling off?" And I said, "Matter of fact, I haven't said this yet, but I want to give a salute to Caterpillar. We breaking ground. I'm excavating. It's going down. Y'all know how I love real estate, and I usually like to build and go up. We going underground now. One time for all my doomsday preppers. Elon Musk, I see you. I saw your ground plans. I'm impressed. But guess what? My bunker going to have a garage. My bunker going to have wings. Huh? Yeah. Yeah, we breaking ground. Huge excavations. You got to have your fluids. I got a water maker, a machine that makes water out of H2O. I got a water maker. We got our canned goods. So if you're thinking the brothers ain't ready, we ready.
I'm gonna have a huge.
Yeah, sit, man. Suck.
No, this is my cousin right here.
Too easy.
Yeah, kind of watch the rest on your own, man. Cause Rick Ross talking folly, man. Trying to saying like how you'd be saved when doom days happen. He says basically the bunker's gonna save him. Basically, when he said he's gonna build some get some wing stop in there. He's gonna say he's got some hate to your water, and that's he's talking holy folly, man. Thinking that can save you when all hell's breaking loose, man. That's what I'm saying. These celebrities, man, they haven't got the mind right, man. Instead of them putting faith in on the Most High, man. Rather put faith on these stupid bunkers, man. So yeah, man. So let me get one more piece before I close out, man. I'm gonna get Proverbs 11:21. Cause these rich ass celebrities, man. Mark Zuckerberg, man. Rick Ross, man. Elon Musk, man. People, man. I haven't got a clue what's about to happen, man. Think that the bunker's gonna save them, man. Bunker's gonna get destroyed, man. So it says, man, Acts 17:30, man, repent, man. People need to repent from their sins, but don't matter if you're a rich celebrity or not, man. You need to repent for your sins, but most of these proud celebrities are not gonna repent, man, because they got a holy pair of riches, man. So when we get Proverbs 11:21, though hand join in hand. The wicked shall not go unpunished, but the seed of the righteous shall be delivered. So, like it says, man, no hand joining the hand, man. The wicked shall not go unpunished, man. God, a lot of these heathens, man, not slacking. A lot of these jakes, man, will not be hand joining the hand with oppressors, man, and other nations, man. The most I said, man, no hand joining the hand, man. The wicked shall not go unpunished, man. Because even, I noticed as well, man, even these, celebrities, man, love to hang around with the heathens, man. So let me one second see if I might get one more priest up here, man, before going down, man. One sec. Is this the one? Can't find, I might just close that store also. See if I can get that one. One sec. It's lucky I can't even find that one. Let me get something else, man. Most of our people are foolish, man. They haven't got a clue what's about to happen, man. It's going to be easy. It's going to be on a gram or on a snatch out or face, man. It's going to be twerking and doing stupidness, man. Calling themselves bad bees and that, man. Doing a whole lot of folly, man. Yeah, man. So that's why people are getting licked down, man.
because I don't want to repent, man. I don't want to keep the laws and the commands, man. Because like, just the other day, man, Jake got licked down in Catford, man. I'm saying, man, to be repenting these last days, man. Doesn't matter if you're in the world or not, man. To be repenting daily, man. Fasting, man. Keeping the commandments, man. And basically having love for, showing love to our own people, man. So, let me get Luke, actually, yeah. Get Luke 13, verse 3. It's the book of Luke, chapter 13, verse 3. I'm going to close out after this, though. Luke, chapter 13, verse 3. I tell you nay, but I set you repent, ye shall all likewise perish. So, as I was saying before, man, most of these celebrities, man, these rich are celebrities, and they're not going to repent, man. These footballers, man, these boxers, man, these rappers, man, they're not going to repent, man. These E's and Jake's are not going to repent. They might say a couple of true stuff, might be saying they believe in God and stuff like that. They might say the Hebrew is that and stuff like that, but really and truly, man, they're not going to come. They have to come out in the house and buy and teach, but most of them, these celebrities, man, they're not putting on fringes, man. They're not basically read the Bible, man, like they're supposed to be reading the Bible, man. Most of these celebrities gonna be stuck in the world, man, buying these fancy cars, man, and carry on buying these mansions and stuff like that. So all that is vanity, man. So actually, let me get Ecclesiastes, man. Get vanity, man, because what all this world represents is vanity, man. So lucky, my last piece I'm gonna get, man. Close out this one, because most of these celebrities they're not gonna repent, man. They got holy pure riches right now, man. They think they can take the riches to the grave, man. Like, man, you can't take the riches with you, man. That's what they felt to understand, man. Yes, yeah, 1 verse 2 slack. Yes, I bring this up. Oh, I'll see that. Yes, yeah, book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 1 verse 2. Vanity of vanities, saith the preacher. Vanity of vanities, all is vanity, man. Like I says in Ecclesiastes 1 verse 2, man. All what this world promotes is vanity, man. Vanity, man. Because when I was in my Snapchat before, man, certain times I might scroll through, man, and like, check a couple of messages and stuff like that. But sometimes I might pick up not my story, but obviously at a little thing at can't say it, man. There's certain stuff that pop up sometimes. I might click on it, man, because I see most of these worldly people, man, that like, still did these that stupid thing when they do back of the world that. The money earphone thing, man. Still want to put money to the hair, man. That don't make no sense at all, man. All that money represents is basically just paper, man. All that soon come to end when Babylon falls, man. Got Jake in the world still want to be doing that money phone thing. Even saw something not too long ago, man. Like before I done this breakdown video, man. So obviously I haven't got this guy, man. I'm not subscribed to this guy on my Snapchat, but obviously certain worldly people, man, might pop up, and I basically sometimes I click on it to see what these worldly people are doing, man. Because obviously you still got got to stay on track what's going on in today's society, man. So because I see a Jake, man, some guy called Rimsey, man, basically reckon he's one lad, he's a Benjamin, man. But obviously most of them these Jakes, man. They have to jump into this the Muslim thing, man. See the guy, because right now it's that wicked it's like I can't even pronounce the word, man. That wicked Ramadan, man. That wickedness, man. And you got these Jakes, man, wearing that long ass gown, man. Shouldn't be doing that, man. They have to be going to these mosques, man. You're Islam, man. So where the hell are these people converting to Islam, man? It's basically like, I wouldn't say it's a scare tactic. It's like, I won't even say it's a scared tactic thing, man, but lots of people, and they're letting their friends letting their friends basically convert them to be a Muslim, man. Because even me, man, when I was in secondary school, man, one month, man, I don't hang around them no more. But when I was in the world, man, that even before I was in the truth, man, that one of my friends used to hang around, man, said, Nathan, man, you might as well turn Muslim, man. I said, I said, nah, I'm not even on that, man. There were times I wasn't going to church, but obviously, certain things just didn't sit well in my spirit, man. I said, I don't even want to be Muslim, man. So from there, but I stopped hanging around with him, man. And basically, that was it, man. Because most of the people, they're thinking that Muslims is the way to get into the kingdom, man. That, man, how can Muslim be the way to get into the kingdom if these Muslims, man, they kiss the Kaaba stone, man? Basically, they worship idols, man. So how can that be the truth, man? It's madness, man. And it even says in the Bible, man, like, they can lick down their wife if they don't listen to them, man. Distract them once, man. Yeah, it's a mad thing still, but what else, man? Basically, it even says in the Bible as well, that says how Israel is basically God's chosen people, man. So how can the Quran be the thing if it's telling you that how Israel is God's chosen people, man? So yeah, enough of rambling on, man. So with that, man, close that, man. Give your praise to the Most High, Yahweh Bashim Yoshai, man. Hoping to be edified when this video comes up, man. So with that, man, I close that, man. Give your praise to the Most High, Yahweh Bashim Yoshai. Shalom. Kwame Shalom.